Hello and
Welcome to the class. We are going to discuss about the voltage regulation in this lecture. So what is voltage regulation? Now in the transformer, practically you all know about that. We want to operate it at practically at a constant voltage, alright. But however, what happens? As the current is taken through the transformer, the load terminal, the secondary side, voltage changes. Okay, because of voltage drop in the internal impedance of the transformer. Alright. So the term voltage regulation is used to identify the characteristics of the voltage change in the transformer with loading. Okay. So what is it? The voltage regulation of a transformer is defined as the arithmetical difference in the secondary terminal voltage between a no load, that is when current is zero, and a full load, that is the current is full, the full current is passing through the circuit at a given power factor. All right, the power factor should be given with the same value of primary voltage for both rated load and no load. All right, so this is what the voltage regulation is. All right, and the numerical difference between no load and full load current voltage, the numerical difference between the no load, secondary no load voltage and secondary full load voltage, just a difference, is called inherent voltage regulation. Inherent voltage regulation. All right. So here you know that this is a voltage at a no load and this is a voltage at the full load. All right. So the per unit voltage regulation, per unit voltage regulation at full load equals to V secondary no load minus V secondary full load divided by V secondary full load. All right. So this is the per unit voltage regulation. And percent voltage regulation, just have a percent voltage regulation at full load, this will equals to V secondary V secondary no load minus V secondary full load divided by V secondary full load into 100. All right, now let's move further. Now let's do the calculation for the voltage regulation. This is the circuit shown over here. It is a equivalent circuit of the transformer referred to the secondary side. All right. So in this circuit, you can see that if you apply the KVL over here, then the voltage V1 upon A should be equals to V2 plus I2 ZE2. All right. V1 upon A should be equals to V2. The current, secondary current, should be flowing over here is I2 over here into ZE2. All right. So we have applied just the KVL over here. Now you know that I2 ZE2 depends on the power factor of the load. This depends on the power factor of the load. ZE2 is equals to RE2 plus JXE2. Okay. So this depends upon the power factor. So the regulation depends on the load power factor. All right. The voltage regulation depends upon the load power factor. So to calculate the regulation, just keep in mind the following steps. Take V2 as reference phasor. All right. Therefore, V2 is equals to V2 angle 0. Okay. Which is equals to V2 plus जे जीरो. सेकेंड थिंग, आई राइट आई टू इन फेजर फॉर्म, आई टू इन फेजर फॉर्म. नाउ फॉर लैगिंग पावर फैक्टर, फॉर लैगिंग पावर फैक्टर, लैगिंग पावर फैक्टर कॉस फाइव टू, व्हेन दिस फॉर लैगिंग, आई टू विल बी इक्वल्स टू आई टू माइनस फाइव टू विल बी द एंगल. ओके, इन केस ऑफ लैगिंग पावर फैक्टर यू नो दैट वी कैन राइट डाउन दिस एज आई टू कॉस फाइव टू एंड माइनस जे इंटू आई टू साइन फाइव टू. ऑल राइट, फॉर लीडिंग पावर फैक्टर कॉस फाइव टू, फॉर लीडिंग पावर फैक्टर cos phi 2, I 2 will be what? I 2 will be I 2, angle should be positive, all right. This will become what? I 2 cos phi 2 plus j I 2 sin phi 2, all right. And for unity power factor, for unity power factor, I2 will be equals to I2 angle 0 equals to I2 plus J 0. Alright. Nesting is what? Nesting, you know that ZE2 will be equals to what? As I have written here also, this will be RE2 and you all know about that, plus JXE2. Alright. Then voltage at no load, voltage, secondary voltage at no load will be equals to what? When there is no load, you know that, when there is no load, so it will become equals to V1 upon A. Okay, V1 upon A equals to V2 angle 0, okay, plus I2 into ZE2. Alright. So, voltage regulation is given by over here. Voltage regulation will be what? Voltage regulation will be, now you all know that the voltage at secondary voltage at no load, secondary voltage at no load equals to V1 upon A. Alright. Minus secondary voltage at full load divided by secondary voltage at full load per unit. Okay, so it is noted that magnitude of the voltage, not their phasor values, determine the regulation. Note that magnitude of the voltage, we have only the magnitude of the voltages, not their phasor values, determine the voltage regulation. Now we are going to calculate, and you will easily understand the voltage regulation at leading power factor first of all. Alright, voltage regulation at lagging power factor, sorry, lagging power factor. So voltage regulation at lagging power factor. Alright, so V2, that is secondary voltage, we have taken this as a reference, V2 angle 0, alright, which is V2 plus J angle 0. I2, since we are taking a lagging power factor, and in case of lagging power factor, we have I2 is equals to I2 minus phi, okay, minus phi 2, which is equals to I2 cos phi 2 minus j I2 sin phi 2. Alright, and ZE2, that is the impedance, total impedance, equals to RE2 plus J into XE2, okay, which is equals to, now here you can see that V1 upon A, okay, the voltage at no load is equals to V2 plus I2 ZE2, as we have also specified earlier, alright, this equals to E2. Alright, so let's put the values of V2 over here first. V2 is what? वी टू प्लस जे एंगल ज़ीरो जे ज़ीरो प्लस आई टू जेड ई टू आई टू इंटू जेड ई टू ओके सो आई टू इंटू जेड ई टू यू नो दैट फर्स्ट आई टू इज वॉट आई टू कॉस फाई टू माइनस जे आई टू साइन फाई टू ऑल राइट एंड वॉट इज जेड ई टू आर ई टू प्लस जे एक्स ई टू ऑल राइट सो लेट्स मल्टीप्लाई एंड पुट रियल टर्म एंड इमेजिनरी टर्म्स पार्ट दिस विल बिकम वी टू प्लस आई टू आर ई टू कॉस फाई टू प्लस आई टू एक्स ई टू साइन फाई टू प्लस जे इन टू आई टू एक्स ई टू कॉस फाई टू माइनस आई टू आर ई टू साइन फाई टू ऑल राइट सो ई टू बिकम वॉट इट विल बिकम अंडर वी टू प्लस आई टू आर ई टू कॉस फाई टू प्लस आई टू एक्स ई टू साइन फाई टू होल स्क्वायर प्लस आई टू एक्स ई टू कॉस फाई टू माइनस आई टू आर ई टू साइन फाई टू स्क्वायर अंडर रूट ऑफ दिस रियल टर्म स्क्वायर प्लस इमेजिनरी टर्म स्क्वायर दिस विल बिकम गिव अस द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑल राइट सो लेट्स ड्रॉ द फेजर डायग्राम ऑफ दिस एंड इट्स प्रीटी इजी If you recall the phasor diagram of the approximate equivalent circuit of the transformer which you have drawn in the last class, so you can easily get this. We have taken V2 as a reference. This will be I2. Since the lagging power factor, so angle should be there. This will be I2 into RE2. The value of RE2 is small. That's 90 degree. Shift we will give and this will give us I2 into XE2. The sum of both these vectors will give us I2 into ZE2. And let's join these points. All right, they give us E2. All right, so this is the phasor diagram of the transformer referred to the secondary side as we have already drawn that. Okay, now per unit regulation, we know that per unit regulation is what we have studied. Per unit regulation, this will give us E2 minus V2 upon V2. All right. So this will give us the result and we are going to put the value of the E2 and the V2 over here. This will give us the voltage regulation and the lagging power factor. One more thing over here, what we are going to consider, just see this term over here. It is very small if we compared with this one. All right. So we can neglect this. It is very small as compared to this. So we can neglect this. And the E2, the value of E2, we will get simply V2 plus I2 RE2 cos phi 2, okay, plus I2 XE2 sin phi 2, all right, so we are going to get this value, and in the per unit voltage regulation at the lagging power factor cos phi 2, when we are going to put these values in the formula given over here, we will get the final results of the voltage regulation. All right, so this is the voltage regulation for lagging power factor. Now let's consider for leading power factor. Now for the leading power factor, there is only one difference, that we have to consider the current I2, which should be equals to I2
and angle should be plus phi 2. All right, this will give us the value I2 cos phi 2 plus j I2 sin phi 2. All right, just this much. When we are going to put these values in the formula given above, E2 will be comes out to be V1 upon A, okay, V2 plus I2 into Z E2. V2, the value of V2, we already know that V2 plus J angle 0 plus I2. I2, what we have got above, I2 cos phi 2 plus J I2 sin phi 2. All right, just put the value of Z E2 over here. Z E2 should be equals to what? R E2 plus J X E2. Okay. Separating the real term and the imaginary term and taking the magnitude of that, we will get the value V2 plus I2 cos phi 2 I2 R E2. R E2 should be multiplied by I2 R E2 cos phi 2 minus I2 X E2 sin phi 2 whole square of this. Okay. Plus I2 X E2 cos phi 2 plus I2 R E2 sin phi 2 whole square. All right. So in this manner, we can calculate the voltage regulation at a leading power factor. All right. One more thing, a similar thing you can do in this also, that the value of this is very small as compared to the value of this figure. All right. So we can neglect that, and we could get the voltage regulation at leading power factor as the new value, you can say that the new value of V2, E2, sorry, we can get that V2 plus I2 RE2 cos phi 2 minus I2 XE2 sin phi 2. Okay, so this is the value of E2 over here. All right, so this is the voltage regulation at leading power factor. And the third condition which we have considered earlier was voltage regulation at unity power factor. At unity power factor, the value of current will become what? I2 will become I2 angle 0, okay, that is I2 plus J0. All right, the value of E2 will become what? E2 will be equals to V2 plus I2 into ZE2. Okay, so V2 is already V2 plus J0 plus I2 become what? I2 plus J0. And the value of ZE2 is what? RE2 plus JXE2. All right. So E2 will become the magnitude of E2, and the putting the square of the real part and the imaginary part, V2 plus I2 RE2 whole square plus I2 into XE2 whole square. This gives the value of E2. Okay, so putting this value of E2 in the formula, we can get the voltage regulation at a unity power factor. All right, so this is all about the voltage regulation of the transformer. Now in this lecture, we are going to have a brief overview of losses in transformer. Okay, losses in transformer. What are the losses in the transformer? The losses which occur in the transformers are, first is iron loss. Iron loss or core loss, you can say. The transformer made up of core, the losses occur in that core are the core loss, or they are also called iron losses. Second thing is a copper loss. The winding, the wire which was wind up on the core of the transformer, and the losses occur due to the resistance and the I square R losses, these are also called I square R loss. Okay, so this is the copper loss and the iron loss and the copper loss of the transformer. Now iron loss consists of iron loss consists of what? Iron loss is the summation of or the sum of hysteresis loss plus the eddy current loss. I hope you have studied about the hysteresis and the eddy current loss. I am not going in deep to explain them. I am just giving you the overview of that. So the value of hysteresis loss is given by KH. This is constant frequency. BM is the maximum flux density to power x. All right. And eddy current loss is given by KE, constant frequency, the square of the frequency, and the square of the maximum flux density of the core. All right. And second thing is the copper loss or I square R losses. Okay, copper loss or I square R losses are what? They are the simply I square R losses. These losses are simply takes place in the primary and the secondary winding because of winding resistance. There is only the ideal condition is that we didn't consider the resistance over there, but actually in practical condition we have the resistance in the wire and the winding over there. So whatever the losses are occurring due to that resistance are simply called as the copper loss or the I square R losses. So these are the main losses occur in the transformers. All right, some are more losses are there. Stray losses which occur due to the leakage flux in the transformer produces eddy current in the conductor tanks. These, okay, so and dielectric losses are also there. Dielectric loss occurs in insulating material, that is the transformer oil and the solid insulation of the transformer. So these are all the also the losses, but they are very small and negligible, so we haven't considered them over here. So that's all about the voltage regulation of the transformer and the brief overview of the losses occurs in the transformer. Okay, thank you. Thanks a lot.